ain't never been in a situation like this before, you know? So that's bad. It's rough.
The Collier County SWAT team was dodging bullets as they tried to find drugs inside an Immokalee home today. The raid happened early this morning on Habitat Center right by Highlands Elementary School. NBC2's Jennifer Vaglis is live there tonight showing us where some of those bullets ended up.
Well, Peter, the shootout originally began here at Habitat Center at this home over here. You can see tonight there are still CCSO crime scene units on scene, but that's not the only home that was struck by bullets across the street on 9th Street North. You're also seeing another home that was struck by one bullet. Now, neighbors want to know who did this. Mary Chain lives on 9th Street North. This morning, around 6 a.m.
I was laying down. I caught myself watching TV, but it was watching me.
Then something startled her.
I heard pop, 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 pop. So I looked out the window, then I looked at the door.
She wasn't dreaming, and it didn't come from her TV. The sounds of gunshots were right outside her window.
Stunned me when I came out because there was so many cars, you know, police cars.
It was backup, responding to a narcotics search warrant gone wrong. CCSO deployed a SWAT team to this home on Habitat Center. People inside and SWAT team members exchanged fire, one neighbor getting in his car to check out the scene. Despite the multiple bullet holes left behind, CCSO says no one was injured. The investigation brought crime scene units to the neighborhood and over a dozen investigators, many going in and out of the Habitat Center home for hours. Others analyzing something in the driveway. Chain says all of it leaves her feeling uneasy.
It was rough. I think I done smoked 3 or 4 cigarettes back to back. Oh, it don't happen again, not this close.
Now, a man that lives at this home says he was home when that bullet struck his home, but he's grateful that tonight his family is okay. I asked the Collier County Sheriff's Office if any arrests have been made and who fired their weapon first. They say this is all part of an active investigation. I'm live in Immokalee tonight. Jennifer Vaglis, NBC2.